Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan, and today I'm going to talk about revisionist historian Rush Limbaugh. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. Click the link, read the story, check out the other donations, make a donation yourself. None of the money goes to us, it goes to charity, so when you donate, you're helping out one of our subscribers and his wife, help them pay medical bills. Because fuck medical debt collectors, fuck those guys. So please, if you have money laying around, you want to donate to a charity, you can at Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. Alright, so this video, I'm warning you, is going to be heavily laced with conspiracy. That's right. I'm going to throw out a shitload of conspiracy theories here. Maybe not a shitload, but some conspiracy theories. And you guys can tell me what you think in the comments section. But alright, here we have Rush Limbaugh. And he's going to go over what really happened during the whole Iraq war thing and George Bush. Thank you to Kyle Kulinski for... I'm using the clip, his clip, because I couldn't find this anywhere. Or I was too lazy to go through it. Whatever. Here we go.
These are the people that told us there are weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. Let's go back to the Iraq War, 2003. George W. Bush spends a year and a half traveling the country, preparing everybody, lobbying the American people to support it. Goes to the United Nations, has satellite photos, all kinds of stuff. Colin Powell up there showing the photos, supposedly, of weapons of mass destruction installations in Iraq.
Doesn't his logo look like, you know, two pairs of, like, asses? There's, like, four butt cheeks up there, just someone bent over. I don't know. Just saying.
Of Saddam Hussein and the European, our allies in the intelligence community, all support this. Now, Bush, as a Republican, probably not popular with the deep state, particularly after how he was elected.
Now, that should already give you pause, right? You should already be like, George Bush wasn't popular with the deep state? What? How does that make sense? Let's continue.
You know, there was outrage, the Florida recount in 2000. A lot of Democrats, a lot of deep staters think that Gore should have been president. He won the popular vote. They think the Supreme Court unfairly put Bush in there. I think there was as much resentment in the deep state, we just didn't call it that then, for George W. Bush as there is today for Donald Trump.
Okay, so what he means by the deep state is he means Democrats. He means Democrats. Now, here's my conspiracy part. I believe that's on purpose. That is on purpose, so it'll turn people who were looking for a revolution in Donald Trump and got jobs and tax cuts, Ronald Reagan, George Bush. They got that version. But they need to create the illusion that they're fighting the bad guys somehow with their military actions or whatever they're doing. All right? It's the deep state. The deep state. You know, Barack Obama, the deep state. Hillary Clinton, the deep state. And it's worked on enough dipshits to where this asshole can say that. And people believe it. Bush wasn't against the war. Or, Bush wasn't for the war. He was against it. It was the deep state that had to lure him and trick him into doing it. You know, when Bernie Sanders was up there complaining about the Iraq war. But they did it anyways. I mean, yeah, this is revisionist history. Where they're just, whatever, to end up turning you Trump guys into George Bush Republicans. They're turning you guys into neocons. I've seen it. I've seen from going from one area where Barack Obama, Libya, Yemen, look at all these wars he's expanding. And when Trump does it, are you ready to fight for America? It's like, oh, you've been turned into neocons. You've been turned into, as far as this country's history is concerned, that's what a traditional Republican is. As far as the guys who get in office, the George Bush, the George H.W. Bush, the Ronald Reagan, the Donald Trump. Neocons. Straight up. All of them. In fact, you could call Bill Clinton and Barack Obama neocons, too. I usually use the word neoliberal because, you know, it's a different character they're playing. So I want to, you know, give a little bit more detail in the diagnosis of this. You know, be a little more detailed with the names. But the destruction of other countries not for you or your protection, but for some other motive, it's like, has been continuing on for decades and decades. And now, this plot, I believe it is a plot to turn, not only to turn Democrats, people who would, you know, normal people who would consider themselves a Democrat or a registered Democrat or a progressive or whatever, trying to turn you guys into normal Armani suit Barack Obama Democrats. And on the other side, the pro-Trumpers, the Republicans, the whoever, even probably the Libertarians, they want to turn you guys into Armani suit Republicans, Donald Trump. They want you, that's not exactly who these guys are, but that's the ideology that they are using, that they're behaving with. And they want you guys to adopt it so that forever and ever you will continuously vote for a shill on the left or a shill on the right. And this is a part of it. Rush Limbaugh's a part of it. He sold that fucking war. Did he not? So he's a part of that shit. And you can might as well throw the conspiracy version of him. Throw Alex Jones in there. He's not doing it too, I believe. Right? We do need to invade Venezuela, or we need to, whatever we're doing is the right thing there, right? But yeah, this dude's definitely a part of it. And the attempt is to make you think that you are fighting the conspiracy deep staters, the creepy crawlies that really, they're the ones that really orchestrate the wars. And our guys just got fooled by it. George Bush got fooled by it. Dick Cheney got fooled by it. Colin Powell got fooled by it. Condoleezza Rice fooled. Where are these other fucking guys? Wolfowitz. Fooled, tricked, bamboozled into going to war with Iraq. And they're going to do the same thing with Obama. He was tricked into it. He's tricked into expanding the wars. Or, no, excuse me. They're not going to say he was tricked into it. That's for the dipshits on the right. On the left, they're going to say it was the most pragmatic solution they can come up with. Come on, use your logic. Use your rationality. It was the most logical, rational answer to come up with, considering the situation. I didn't start these wars. I didn't start the housing crisis. It was the other guy. And because of all that guy's mistakes, I have to clean them up. And the only rational solution and the only rational way forward is through what I did. Expand two wars into seven. You know, we need to expand the carnage across the entire Middle East, not just Iraq and Afghanistan, and he's spread. They wouldn't say it like that, obviously, but they want to turn you guys into these dipshits, to where they give you the illusion you're fighting, they're giving you the illusion that you're in the conspiracy, like you're walking amongst it, and you got to fight it. And who's the deep stater? Who's the one doing this conspiracy? It's the Democrats. Democrats are evil. They're the deep state. Fuck's sakes, man. I'll play more of this bullshit.
And if not the same, it's close. I think, how could so many different intelligence agencies get something so wrong?
They didn't. They didn't get it wrong. They purposely bullshitted everyone. And Bush and his whole administration purposely bought it. It wasn't, they weren't tricked into it. They were like, yeah, let's go with that. Just like Dick Cheney trying to sell the story, the Soleimani story of he killed 600, over 600 Americans. And then you see Trump using it now. That's not by accident. That's not by mistake.
As weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. And remember, they gave Bush mounds of satellite photo evidence, documentation evidence. Colin Powell was dispatched to the United Nations to present this evidence, and it was all bogus. Because we went in there, it was the pretext for invading Iraq after 9/11. We get in there, and there are no weapons of mass destruction. It was one of the most embarrassing things. The Bush administration had to scramble. Everybody had to scramble. What I have seen, this bunch of people in the intelligence community capable, what they've tried with Trump here, this whole Russia meddling, Trump colluding, this whole thing is a gigantic lie, a totally bogus hoax.
Or a part of the Pied Piper strategy, maybe. But I was going to say, do you guys remember Nancy Pelosi on CNN saying that, she knew they were wrong about Iraq. She knew the intelligence was flubbed, was fucked up, or bullshit. She knew that. And then she said she wouldn't, she still didn't go for the impeachment. Why didn't she go for the impeachment? She says because these guys, these other guys, presented their case. They presented a case. The Bush administration presented a case for this. So it's like, was that by accident? Was that a mistake? Did Nancy Pelosi let him go because it was a mistake? No. Did deep state, which are the Democrats, trick them into presenting information to them? Or the deep state Democrats tricked the George Bush administration into presenting evidence back to the deep state Democrats in order for them to say yes. They lured them into a trap, you see. That's how it's working. Fucking idiots. Jesus Christ. Now, Trump fans probably don't like Rush Limbaugh because of his selling of these wars and all of that. But they might like him now because Trump gave him a medal. Why would Trump do that? I thought Trump was against the neocons. But then Rush is telling you the neocons aren't the neocons. They're innocent actors who were tricked by the Democratic deep state. Do you see the entangled mess you are now in if you subscribe to Donald Trump is a good guy saving us and protecting us? You have now tripped 18 fucking times over like 34 shoelaces. That's how deep this goes. I'll play more. Here you go.
A silent coup. That's when I began to think the weapons of mass destruction thing was a setup against Bush, too. My point is this. Why should we believe these people?
Thanks, Kyle. Why should we believe these people? You shouldn't. Which would make me say, why should we believe you? Because you were selling the same things they were selling. How do we know this isn't reverse psychology? But that might be too much deep of thinking for people to, for some of these Trump fans to like really like, but what if Rush is lying? What if he's just blaming the other side, the Democrats, as these deep state guys, when really it's both sides and they're both trying to screw me over? And in fact, the plot is to turn me back into a George Bush Republican. And here's the avenue to do it. To say Bush was innocent. He was just lied to by other people, by the deep state, by Democrats. They lied to him. And they got him into this war. And we spent all this time blaming George Bush when really he was innocent. And then Barack Obama, he knew what he was doing because he's the deep state, because he's a Democrat. Fucking stupid. Of course, Israel doesn't come up in this conversation. I'm pretty sure they played a heavy role in regards to the intelligence. Russia will not go against Israel. I'm pretty sure they presented a decent amount of information, a decent amount of intelligence, right? Didn't Israel present a shitload of evidence that you're now calling the deep state? These intelligence communities, you can't trust them. What if the intelligence came from Israel and told them there was WMDs there? What would Rush do there? Ah, Rush would back off and make sure not to mention Israel. Why? Because he's not actually fighting the deep state. He's not actually doing that. He's trying to trick you. And if you bought it, you've been tricked. If you aren't in the lane that Donald Trump is a neocon, you have been tricked. Congratulations. You are now a George Bush voter. And James would say you're worse than a George Bush voter because you already had George Bush. You already had the lesson from 8 years of George Bush to where it's like, never trust that shit again. And now the guy's just doing it again in a different mask. You know, he talks shit, so he must be a normal guy. We go into Syria. We take over parts of their territory. And we tell everyone we're keeping the oil. And that doesn't register as neocon to you. Oh, a neocon would hide it. Right? George Bush would hide that. He's really there for oil. Donald Trump says it out loud. He's proud. He can't be a neocon. You've been tricked. You're probably losing IQ points as you further believe this bullshit. But whatever. That's it for me. Please subscribe if you feel like, comment, agree, disagree. Tell me what you think. Is Rush correct? Is he correct? Is it really just a Democratic deep state? The Democrats are the deep state, right? Or are they all but just a bunch of liars? And they're tricking you to put you back into the scenario of a left-right paradigm. Because that keeps you guys docile. No more revolution, we just need to defeat the Democrats, that's it. No more revolution, just defeat the Republicans. That's what I think TYT is doing. TYT is trying to draw you back into normalized Democrats as politicians. Right? It keeps their show alive because they get to complain about it. They say, look, Barack Obama did something bad here. But it was a mistake. He did it by mistake. He's not purposely trying to screw people over. He's doing it by accident. See, he's so nice. He's trying to be nice. I'm sure HS Mac is going to provide a link. Like, no, they complained. Yeah. Comment section. Don't forget to donate Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you want to get him.